generalizations of LP spaces.
I'm going to present some results which was obtained jointly with Janusz Matkowski from University of Zielona Góra. Let me start with some definitions and notations. Given a measure space omega sigma mu with node by S, the linear real space of all mi integrable simple functions X mapping omega into R. For any bijective function phi, mapping 0 infinity into itself, such that phi of 0 is equal to 0, we define P phi mapping S into this set by the following formula. If phi is defined by us a power function with the power P not less than 1, the functional P phi becomes the LP norm in the space S. Assuming that P phi is a paranorm in S, and either phi is superquadratic or related to variable function satisfies a certain nice condition, we prove that this space is uniformly convex and a modulus of the convexity of this space is given. This results extending the classical Clarkson theorem concerning the case when phi is a power function may be useful, for instance, in the proof of Brader-Gede-Kirk fixed point theorem and its generalization, for example, Pasicki theorems. Now some definitions. Let X be a real linear space. A function P mapping X into R is called a paranorm in X if the following conditions are satisfied. The first one, P of X is equal to 0 if and only if X is equal to 0. P of minus X is equal to P of X for all X from X. And P is subadditive, that is, this inequality holds. And this implication holds true. Tn tends to t for r, p of xn minus x tends to 0, then this value tends to 0. If p is a paranorm in x, then this space is called a paranorm space. We say that a paranorm space xp is uniformly convex if for all positive r, epsilon from this set exists positive delta belongs to 0 r, such that this implication holds for all x, y from x. The value of p of x and y is not greater than r. P of x minus y is greater equal epsilon. These conditions imply that P of arithmetic mean of xy is not greater than r minus delta. The function delta mapping this set into positive half line is referred to as a modulus of convexity of space xp. The Mainz results let phi be an increasing bijection such that P phi is a paranorm in the space S. If phi is superquadratic, that is, phi satisfies this inequality, then the space, this space is uniformly convex. And the function delta, given by this formula, is its modulus of the convexity of the space X S P phi. In the proof of this theorem, we use the following lemma. We assume that phi is a bijection such that phi of 0 is 0. And if phi is super quadratic, then this inequality holds true. Now, short proof of theorem 1. Take arbitrary points from delta, and then x, y from S such that these inequalities hold. Putting x1 as arithmetic means of x and y, y1 by the following form, we have that x is the sum of x1, y1, and y is the difference between both of them. And as phi is increasing, we have the following inequality. Moreover, from the subadditivity of p phi, we obtain this condition. That is, we know that p phi of y1 is not less than epsilon 2. From lemma 2, we get the following conditions, which is equivalent to this one. Hence, as phi is increasing, we have the following inequalities, and thus the value p phi of the arithmetic mean of x and y is not greater than r minus delta depends on r l epsilon, which completes the proof. Some corollaries connected with this theorem. Assume that the measure of the omega is not greater than 1. And if phi is an increasing bijection and the function f, capital F, mapping this product into non-negative half line, given by this formula is concave, then p phi is a paranorm in this space. If in addition the phi is super quadratic, then the space is uniformly convex and the function delta is given by this form and delta is its modulus of the convexity. Now we assume that the function phi is twice differentiable functions. Phi of 0 is 0, and the derivative first and the second derivative of phi in the point L is not less than 0. We assume also that the first derivative over the second derivative is super quadratic on the positive half line. Then this space is a paranorm space. If in addition the phi is a super quadratic, then this space is uniformly convex and the function delta given by this formula is its modulus of the convexity. One of the examples for a fixed p greater than 2, we consider the function phi p given by this formula, t power p over t plus 1. Then we have the first derivative of phi over the second derivative of phi in the point t is given by this form. A standard computation shows that this function is increasing in the set 0 infinity. Hence, we infer that this function is super quadratic in the positive half line. Moreover, if p is equal to 3, then for positive RS, we obtain this condition, which shows that phi 3 is super quadratic. Thus, there are non-power functions satisfying the assumptions of corollary 4. The next corollary deals with measure satisfying the conditions different from the inequality that measure of omega is less equal 1. Assume that for every set A, either the measure of A is 0 or the measure of the set A is not less than 1. Let phi be an increasing bijection, convex and geometrically convex. Then P phi is paranorm in this space. If in addition phi is superquadratic, then this space is uniformly convex, and function delta given by this formula is its modulus of convexity. The next example, the function phi is given as t power 2 a power t, is an increasing bijection, convex and geometrically convex. Setting the function f of Rs in the following way, we have that the value at the point 0, 0 is 0. Making some calculation, one can check that the derivatives with respect to the first and second variable are non-negative, so the function f is increasing with respect to each variable. It follows that the value of Rs is not less than 0 for all such arguments. That is, the function phi is superquadratic. Consequently, phi satisfies the assumptions of colorary 6. Some lemma. Phi is a bijection such that phi of 0 is 0, and H, mapping this product into this set, is given by the following formula. Then this inequality holds for all x and y if and only if the function H, capital H, satisfies this condition. Ai is the measure of the set A, capital I, for, and this condition holds for some pairwise disjoint sets A1 up to AK. The next theorem, phi is increasing bijection such that the P phi is a paranorm in this space. Assume that the phi is strictly convex and the function H capital given by this formula satisfies this condition, conditions from the lemma. Then this space is uniformly convex and there is a modulus delta, convexity of this space, which satisfies this equality. Some corollaries. Assume that the measure of omega is not greater than 0. Phi is increasing bijection and the capital F given by this form is concave. Then P phi is a paranorm in the space S. If in addition phi is strictly convex and the function H given by this form is convex, then this space is uniformly convex and there is a modulus delta of convexity of it. Now we assume that mi is the counting measure on a set omega, subset of the natural set. If phi is increasing bijection, convex, geometrically convex, then P phi is a paranorm in this set. If, in addition, phi is strictly convex and the function H given by this form is subadditive, then this space is uniformly convex and there is modulus delta of its convexity. finally, we deal with the special case of the finite set omega, then consider space S is Rk. We establish the uniform convexity of this space generated by a strictly convex bijection phi, mapping this set into itself. Let phi be a strictly convex bijection, such P phi is a paranorm in Rk, then this space is uniformly convex. A contrario proof of this fact provides no information on a modulus of the convexity of this space. In some case, it can be done, even an exact formula of a modulus can be proved. We show how to make it in details in the case when S is R square and phi is given by this function. This theorem is as follows. P phi is paranorm in S square given by this form. The phi is given by this formula. Then the function delta naught given by this formula is strictly increasing with second variable. This point is the unique solution of this equation. Moreover, the function delta, defined as delta naught at the point R epsilon 4, is a modulus of convexity of space R2. And the list of reference. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you for your talk. Some questions or remarks to the speaker?
In the definition of the modulus of convexity, did you take the best modulus or any modulus? Yes, because in the best, at least in the dimension should be at least two. And here you don't have this. Thanks.
Some other questions? Remarks? If no, thank you again.
Actually, I would like to make an announcement. It's not remarks. It was a nice talk. Thank you. But just announcement. Tomorrow we'll have a general assembly of a group of generalized convexity. In fact, everybody is welcome. Everybody is invited. It will be 5:30, right after the plenary talk, and we don't expect to stay long, really. There are some issues to discuss, and would appreciate it.